doctor is in. Less travel, fewer work commitments, and a lot more downtime has been a big help for couples trying to conceive, and pregnancies are on the rise. But being pregnant during COVID times can be very difficult. Joining us today is Dr. Keisha Gaither to discuss health challenges, nutritional needs, and mental health support for expectant moms. Welcome to Bloom, Doctor.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So I understand that you have been seeing a lot more pregnancies during the pandemic.
Oh my goodness. It is such an astronomical boom. You wouldn't believe it.
That's great, because I know a lot of people want to conceive and sometimes it can be so difficult. But have there been any complications associated with COVID?
Well, I mean, I think one of the things that should be understood is that during pregnancy, there's a physiologic decrease in your immune function. And the body is smart. It depresses your immune system to allow your baby, which is seen as foreign, to grow and to thrive. And COVID is a nasty little player that seems to like those immune systems that are depressed. So COVID most naturally will be seen a lot in pregnancy, definitely. And certainly if you have any comorbid issues such as diabetes, you're really at an increased risk of contracting the illness.
That's interesting, because I do remember the CDC listed pregnancy as a risk factor for COVID-19. Now I understand why. So
yes.
Is that why you stand behind pregnant women getting the vaccine?
Absolutely. You know, the American College of OBGYN certainly advocates it. I certainly advocated, and being a high-risk doctor and seeing a lot of pregnancies that have comorbid complications, I absolutely recommend it. It's life-saving.
So what happens, though, if a pregnant woman does contract COVID-19? How does that play out throughout the pregnancy and delivery?
Well, here's the thing. You know, when COVID first came on the scene, a lot of the patients that were positive ended up in the intensive care unit. Okay. Now, a couple of months later, what I find is a lot of asymptomatic patients. I haven't had anybody this year in the intensive care unit. A lot of bad outcomes last year when it first came on the scene, maternal deaths, people in the ICU, but now not so much. What I am seeing a lot of, and this is, I find interesting, when I'm doing prenatal diagnosis of the baby during an anatomy scan, there are times that I can see fluid around the baby's heart. That's called a pericardial effusion. Mm. And when I see that, the mom may be symptomatic. When I test her for COVID, she's positive. So I think what is happening is COVID is going across the placenta and interacting with the baby, causing these findings. You know, COVID does impact, you know, cardiac muscles. So.
Wow.
This is, I'm seeing it a lot.
Wow, that is interesting to hear. Because I know everything is so new, and doctors and medical experts like yourself are just learning along the way. I wanted to ask you about the mental well-being of moms-to-be, because I remember it did from my first to my fourth. I was very anxious during my pregnancies, because you want to make sure that you're doing everything right, you're eating everything right, you don't want to take on any kind of responsibility for something going wrong with a pregnancy. I would imagine that your patients must be so anxious right now, being pregnant during a pandemic.
Well, you know, it's interesting. Last year, yes, there was a lot of anxiety, and, you know, understandably so. New pandemic, what do you do? Where do you go? Can you go? But now I think there's a tampering down of the anxiety. You know, I believe that the patients now know that what to expect when they come to their doctor's office. Certainly, you know, staggered visits, so there's not a lot of people in the waiting room. Everybody is in their PPE, you know, lots of hand washing, stringent criteria about who comes to labor and delivery and so forth and so on. So I think, you know, there's a lessened degree of anxiety, certainly compared to last year.
Doctor, we have about a minute left, but the importance of the, you know, going to see your doctor for the prenatal checkups and postnatal checkups.
Absolutely. And one thing that I can say to help boost immunity is to use vitamin D. Vitamin D is a vitamin that's made in the skin in conjunction with sunlight. Less so in women that are melanated. Now that everybody's in the house, I'm certain the vitamin D levels have plummeted. Vitamin D is very important in boosting immunity and help helpful in allaying the risk of preterm labor. You can have your physician check it, or you can go to a great website, powerofd.org, to check out all of the vitamin supplements that are helpful. You need to have a vitamin D level of 40 to 60 nanograms per milliliter. So one thing that women can do, particularly if they're pregnant and diabetic, is to take on some vitamin D supplementation.
All right, thank you so much, doctor. I want to repeat those websites. For more information, you can go to KeishaGaither.com, and about the vitamin D, visit powerofd.org. And to follow the doctor, you can find her on Twitter at KeishaGaitherMD. We'll be back with more Bloom right after this. Thanks, doc.